Welcome to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to be talking about conics, about the conic section, and in particular the parabola. This is usually skills taught in Algebra 2 course. We're going to look at the vertex, axis of symmetry, direction, and extreme value to help us to actually graph and find out what this particular parabola looks like. So to begin, we're going to take this function that we have here, y equals 1 half x squared, 1 half times x squared plus 3, and put that into a more standard form by subtracting 3 from both sides. It's going to leave us with y minus 3 is equal to 1 half x squared. Now we're able to see easily, or more clearly, what the vertex is. In this case here, the x is the only term that's being squared, so it's understood that the x value of the vertex is 0, and then the y value of the vertex is the opposite of what we see, so that would be a positive 3. Now we're going to try to find the axis of symmetry. Being that the x is the variable being squared, that means that our axis of symmetry is going to lie along the x value, and in this case where x is equal to 0. The direction, we need to find out what the p-value is. In this particular example, the p-value is greater than 0. The p-value is 1 half. And being that it's greater than 0, that means that the parabola opens in an upward position, giving us this general view of the parabola. And lastly, our extreme value, since it opens up, is going to have a minimum value. And that minimum value is going to be a y-value that is equal to the y-value that we found for the vertex. In this case, y is equal to 3. Now, to better understand some of the intercepts, if they exist for this particular function, we're going to start off by trying to find our y-intercept. To find our y-intercept, that means we're going to substitute in the value of 0 for x so we can find out what y is at that particular point. So in this case, y minus 3 is equal to 1 half times 0 squared. We know that anytime you multiply something by 0, the result is 0. So everything to the right hand side of the equal sign becomes 0. And now we want to isolate the y variable, which means we have to add 3 to both sides. So we know that when the x value is 0, the y value is 3. And what you'll also notice is that that matches our vertex. So we'll take a closer look at that once we switch to the graphing software to see what this function looks like. Next, we want to find the x-intercepts. So to find the x-intercepts, we want to know that when the y value is 0, what are the value or values of x if they exist? So in this case, we're going to say y is 0 minus 3 is equal to 1 half x squared. All we did was come back here to this standard equation that we have here and substitute in 0 for the y. As we begin to evaluate, we have negative 3 is equal to 1 half times x squared. I want to get that x squared by itself, so I'm going to divide both sides by 1 half. And I see here that I have a whole number, and I'm dividing it by a fraction. So I'm going to change negative 3 into a fraction, negative 3 over 1, and multiply by the reciprocal, which would be 2 over 1. And that's going to give me this here on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, 1 half divided by 1 half simplifies down to 1, leaving us with just an x squared. I'm going to evaluate what's on the left-hand side here. Negative 3 times a positive 2 leaves me with a negative 6. I'm not going to worry about the denominator because it's 1 times 1, and negative 6 is understood to have a denominator of 1, and rewrite the right-hand side. I see here that I have a negative 6 is equal to x squared. Well, we know from previous classes and other tutorials that any time you square a number, the result is going to always be positive. So being that we're not getting a positive result here, when this x is being squared, we know that no real solutions exist. And since we have no real solutions, that basically means that we do not have any x-intercepts. All right, so let's recap the information that we have. No x-intercepts, a y-intercept at 0.03, vertex is also at 0.03, axis of symmetry is at x equals 0, which is along the y-axis. We know that it should point up, and we know that the minimum y value that we should see is equal to 3. So let's take a switch to our drawing software, and I've pre-done that for us. Here we have the parabola defined, y equals 0.5 x squared plus 3. 0.5 is the same thing as 1/2. So this here is the parabola. We see that we have a vertex here at 0.3, like we stated earlier. And we also see that that vertex is right here on the y-axis, which is at point, which is the vertical line at x equals 0. And then we see that our minimum value for y is right here where y equals 3, because as we continue up the graph, we see that the y values are becoming larger and larger. So I want to conclude this video here showing the drawing of our parabola. Thank you for tuning in to Spell Tutorial Services. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and have a good evening.